Okay, students, today we see about the seed and fruit development. So, how the seed and fruits are produced? Okay, so we have seen the fertilization process. After the fertilization, here how the changes takes place, first we see that is about so here we have seen that is the ovule. Okay, so anatropous ovule, from which there is the formation of seed, that is the ovule which converts after fertilization, ovule converts into the seed, and the ovary which converts into the fruit. Ovary converts into the fruit. Then here in the ovule we have seen for the structure of the ovule, that is the outermost covering of the ovule, it is known as the integuments. So these integuments which mainly converts into the seed coat. So there are the two integuments. Okay, so here the outer integument, it converts into the testa, which is the thick. Testa is the thick, while here the inner integument, it is known as the tegma. So the seed coat, that is here testa, it is the outermost covering, and tegmen, it is the inner, that is the inner covering, that is the thin. Then integuments, inside the integument there is the nucellus. So in some seeds the nucellus, it mainly used for the development of endosperm and also for the embryo, but in some seeds here the nucellus remains as it is, that is the part of the nucellar cells, that is it persists. Okay, and it converts into the thin papery covering, which is known as the perisperm. It converts into the perisperm. So this perisperm, it mainly occurs, that is in the black paper. The perisperm is present. Majority in the seeds, that is the nucellus, is utilized for the development of the embryo and the endosperm. Then inside the nucellus, there is the embryo sac. Okay, so here inside the embryo sac, there is the first, see, that is the egg cell. Okay, after fertilization, it converts into the zygote, which is the diploid zygote. Okay, and here this diploid zygote, it converts into the embryo. Okay, so here from the zygote embryo development takes place. We have seen already how embryo development takes place is. Then again here the inside the nucellus, that is in the embryo sac, there is the secondary nucleus, and this secondary nucleus after fertilization, it converts into the pen, that is the primary endospermic nucleus. Okay, so here the primary endospermic nucleus, it is the triploid, and this primary endospermic nucleus, it converts into the endosperm, which is the nutritive mass in present in the seed. Okay, then again here in the embryo sac we have seen that is there is the egg cell which is towards the chalazal, micropylar end. Then there are the two synergids. Okay, so here the synergids, it gets degenerate. Degenerated. Okay, then again antipodal cells are also present. So these antipodals, these are also gets degenerate. Okay, so here the antipodal cells and the synergid after fertilization gets degenerate. Then here there is the micropyle also, that is a small opening which is present towards the micropylar end. Okay, so here the micropyle, which is the small opening, it remains and in on the integument of the seed, that is a small pore. Okay, so here it acts as a small pore and it mainly useful to entry the water and the oxygen during the seed germination. So here the micropyle, which is small opening present in the ovule, through which during the fertilization pollen tube enters. Okay, then here one most important function of the micropyle, that is after the fertilization, when from the ovule seed is produced, that is the micropyle, that is small opening, remain as it is. It acts as a small pore, okay, through which here the water enters, also the oxygen enters through the small opening or the small pore, and here the germination of the seed takes place. Okay, so these are some changes which takes place after fertilization, that is from the ovule seed formation takes place, from the ovary fruit formation takes place. Okay, then from the integuments here the seed coat is produced. Okay, so here the outer seed coat, it is known as the testa, and inner seed coat, it is known as the tegumen. Then here the nucellus, in some seeds the nucellus, it mainly used for the development of embryo and the endosperm, so it completely disappear, but in some seeds it remains as it is and it converts into the perisperm. Then here the secondary nucleus after fertilization, from which here the primary endospermic nucleus is produced and then endosperm development takes place. We have seen already how the development of endosperm takes place. Then from the egg, here egg which fuses with the one male gamete and produce the diploid zygote, from which here the embryo development takes place. Then again the synergids, which are present around the egg cell, that is on the both side of the egg cell, these synergids gets degenerate, that is disappear. Then antipodal cells, it also gets degenerate after fertilization. Then micropyle, which remains as a small opening or the small pore on the seeds, and these are mainly useful to entry the water and the oxygen during the germination of the seed. Okay, so these are the some changes after the fertilization. So next is, that is about how the seed formation takes place, that is about the seed, and then again we can see how the fruit is. So here the seed, it mainly after fertilization, that is from the ovule seed formation takes place. So seeds, these are mainly the two types of the seeds. Okay, so one is the monopod seed and another is the dicot seed. So there are the two types of the seeds, that is in the monopod also there are the two types of the seeds. One is the non-endospermic seed or it is also known as the ex-albuminous seed. Ex-albuminous seed. Another is the endospermic seed. Endospermic seed, which is known as the albuminous seed. Okay, so in the monopod, that is endospermic seed, in which here the endosperm which remains as it is. Okay, it is not used for the development of embryo. Okay, so here it is the albuminous seed, So example of the endospermic monocot are the maize, jawar, coconut. It is also the endospermic seed. Okay, so in monocot also there are the non-endospermic seed. For example, in case of the orchids, there are the non-endospermic seed. These are also known as the ex-albuminous seed. So what is mean by endospermic seed and non-endospermic seed? So in the endospermic seed, here the endosperm which remain as it is, and here the embryo, it is very small, that is the cotyledons are very small. While in the non-endospermic seed, here the endosperm is completely used for the development of embryo. Okay, so see, that is here in case of the dicot seeds, there are also two types of the seed. One is the non-endospermic seed. And endospermic seed. Okay, so here endospermic seed, it is known as the albuminous seed. So endospermic dicot seed, example is the castor. Castor seeds, these are mainly the endospermic dicot seed. While non-endospermic seed, there are the example, these are the pea or the beans or the grams. These are the example of the non-endospermic seed. Okay, so in this seed also, that is in the non-endospermic seed, here the endosperm is completely used for the development of embryo. Okay, so see, that is in case of the bean or the pea, that is in this seeds, if we see, that is outer seed coat, if we remove the seed coat, we can see only the structure of the embryo. There is no endosperm. So all the endosperm is utilized for the development of embryo, due to which in this type of the seeds, here the cotyledon remains becomes thick. So see, that is here, for example, in case of the bean or the pea, we can see here the structure. So there are the two cotyledons. Which mainly becomes thick due to the storage of the food material. Okay, so these are the two cotyledons. Then, see, that is here is the seed coat. Like this. Then here is the radical. Radical. Here. We can see that is the, there is the plumule, here is the plumule. Okay, these are the two cotyledon. And whole this structure, that is the plumule, radical and the cotyledon, it is the embryo. It is the embryo. Okay. And here there is the covering, that is the seed coat. Okay. So in this type, that is, it is the non-endospermic dicot seed in which endosperm is utilized for the development of embryo. So in case of the pea or the bean, we can see that is the cotyledons. These are the thick cotyledons. Because here, in this type of the seeds, here the food is stored into the cotyledon. Okay, so here the cotyledons are thick. It is the non-endospermic seed. That is the dicot seed. Okay, so here in case of the endospermic dicot seed, we can see that is in the castor, that is in the castor we can see the two cotyledons, but these two cotyledons are the papery, while here the endosperm, it mainly in which here the food stores. Okay, so here the food stored in the endosperm, So in this type of the seed, endosperm remain as it is. Endosperm is thick, while the cotyledons are papery. Okay, in the castor seeds. Okay, so here the food material is stored into the endosperm. So here endosperm remains as it is, but there are the two cotyledons. Okay, so here it is the dicot seed, castor seed. Okay, so these are the two examples of the dicot seeds, that is the endospermic seed and the non-endospermic seed and the endospermic seed. Then next, that is about the non-endospermic seed in case of the monocot. That is, here example is the orchid. While in the endospermic seed, there are the example, these are the mage and the jawar. So, in this also we can see, that is the diagram. See, that is here how the structure of the mage seed is. That is, if we see, that is in the mage seed, here the endospermic seed is there. That is, in which here we can see, that is the endosperm remains as it is. It is not utilized for the development of embryo. Okay, so in which here we can see, that is there is the endosperm, like this here, it is the endosperm. This portion is the endosperm. So here in which here the food is stored in the endosperm, while the portion of the embryo is very small. See, that is here, it is the scutellum. Okay, scutellum is the cotyledon, that is single cotyledon present in the monocot, that is a mono single cotyledon is present. So it is the scutellum, and here the scutellum in which there is the in the embryo, here is the plumule, and here this plumule, it is covered by the protective covering. We have seen also, that is the polioptile. Protective covering of the plumule is known as the polioptile. Then here, see, that is here is the radical portion, and this radical, this radical it is covered by the protective covering. It is known as the coleorrhiza. So here protective covering of the radical is known as coleorrhiza, while here the protective covering of the plumule is known as coleoptile. So this small portion is known as the embryo. So this whole portion is the embryo. So here in this endospermic seed, that is in the monocot endospermic seed, food material is stored into the endosperm. And here in this endosperm, it is covered, the covering, that is the protective covering, it is known as the aleuron layer. This protective covering is known as the aleuron layer. And then again here, whole this seed, it is covered by the seed coat, and here the fruit wall also, seed coat and fruit wall. So here it is together is known as the hull. So it is the seed coat plus fruit wall. Together is known as the hull, because here this structure, that is nothing but the grain. It is known as the grain. That is here the fruit wall and seed coat are together. Okay, so it is the seed coat and fruit wall is together protective covering, that is known as the hull. Okay, and inside which there is the layer, it is known as the aleuron layer. aileron layer. Okay, so see, that is here in this type of the seed, that is, it is the endospermic seed. Okay, it is known as the albuminous seed, in which here the endosperm remains as it is. It is not completely used for the development of embryo, so it is the endospermic seed. Okay, so in this endospermic seed, here the food material is stored inside the endosperm. Okay, so here endosperm is thick and the cotyledons, these are the thin. Okay, while here in the non-endospermic seed, that is, the cotyledons are thick. Okay, due to the storage of food material, and here the whole endosperm is utilized for the development of embryo. So here embryo, we can see, that is a large embryo. Only embryo is present. Endosperm is completely absent in the non-endospermic seed. Okay, so it is about the seed. Okay, so here we see, that is about the types of the seed. That is, there are the two types of the seed, that is monocot and dicot, in which there are the two types. One is the non-endospermic seed and the endospermic seed also. Okay, so it is about the seed. Then next seed part, about the fruit. Okay, so here we have seen, that is, the from the ovule seed formation takes place, and from the ovary, that is, the development of fruit takes place. Okay, so here the ovary after fertilization converts into the fruit. So here if we see the fruit, that is the wall of the fruit, it is known as the pericarp. Wall, fruit wall, is known as the pericarp. And here the pericarp mainly having the three layers, that is, outermost is the epicarp, middle mesocarp, and innermost, that is the endocarp. So this structure we can see, that is, in apple or in case of the mango. If we see the structure of the mango, that is, in the mango, if we see, that is, here the outermost, that is, the thin wall, it is the epicarp, and here this middle portion, which is the edible portion, it is the mesocarp, which is the fleshy portion. Mesocarp is the fleshy portion, and here there is the endocarp. It mainly the thick endocarp. Okay, so these three together, it is known as the pericarp. Okay, so majority in the mango, if we see, that is, in the mango, mesocarp is edible, thick is the endocarp, and inside which we can see, that is, there is the seed. So here is the seed. So it is the structure of the fruit, that is the typical fruit. If we see the typical fruit, we can see the structure in which, like this. Okay, so here the seeds and the fruit development. Then next, that is, what are the significance of the seed and the fruit. So here the fruit, it mainly provide nutrition or the nourishment to the seed. Okay, so here the seeds, which are if in immature condition, it also gives the protection to the seed. So what is the significance or the function of the fruit? That is, fruit, it gives nourishment or nutrition to the seed. Also, then again, next, that is significance, that is, here the fruit. It protect also the immature seeds. Then here the seeds are mainly here the useful for the propagating organ, useful as a propagating organ. That is, that is from the seeds, new plant is produced. Okay, so it is used as a propagative organ. That is in many plants. Okay, many angiospermic plant. And then here the seeds and the fruit, these having the one most important significance, that is they are having some dispersal devices, that is to move from one place to the another place, and for this due to this movement here the distribution of the fruit and the seeds takes place. That is, in some seeds we see that is there are the hairy outgrowth due to which they can be moved from one place to the another place. Then some seeds having the wing like outgrowth due to which they can move from one place to the another place. That is for the distribution of the seeds. And also in some fruit also there are some devices, that is for the dispersion. Okay, so these are some in significance of the seeds and the fruits. Okay, so here we complete about the seed and the fruit development. Today we see that is in the seeds, how the endospermic seeds and non-endospermic seeds are. We have also seen some examples. Then fruit, in which we have seen that is wall of the fruit is known as the pericarp. A pericarp having the three layers, that is the outermost layer is the epicarp, then middle mesocarp, and innermost is the endocarp, that is in a typical fruit, and inside which there is the seed. Okay, so here it is about the fruit development. Okay, so today we complete here, that is the seed and the fruit development.